one, two, three, clap it off.
Yeah, I'm gonna need a microphone right here.
Clap on, clap off.
Even if I'm not in the video.
Jeez. Jeez Louise.
Already starting.
I'm gonna have to teach you so much whenever you get that
to a winning event.
One, two, three. Okay, cool.
So I didn't even have a mic, so.
Sky, get out of the way. Come on. Get out of the way.
Go to the bathroom.
I don't want
to
run you over.
Should I close the bathroom?
I mean, so it will, but
echo?
No, I've found that you can like leave both doors open and it's actually fine.
Okay, I'll close it.
So we can reopen that door so that way air gets in.
Yep.
Yeah,
gets
out
so we don't die.
That would be nice.
Indeedly dizzle. I'm sorry, guys.
Look.
So yeah, giant dildos in the intestines.
A good way to start us off.
It's a euphemism for the podcast.
Yeah,
pretty much, man. You ever like go back and listen to them and you're like, why would anybody fucking listen to this ever? And that's not even being self-deprecating.
No.
That's me being honest with myself.
Like, genuinely, we're awful.
Correct.
Much like the podcast, at the end, I sit there and go, how did I get here?
Why am I here? What are we talking about?
Fan.
Yeah.
And now you're
all 12 inches.
You won a contest.
Yeah.
This is the
remember joining. Thank you.
This is the shittiest contest you've ever been a part of. Congratulations. You're now the best fucking member.
And it ends in surgery, just like the 12 inch dildo.
Welcome to the MetaVillains podcast.
How is everybody doing?
How are you doing?
Let's give him a second to respond.
I was waiting for our only fan to respond.
Oh, yes. Shitty, Jared. Shitty.
Well, isn't that Matt guy our biggest fan now?
Yeah, I guess.
Because I allowed it to happen.
He takes the helm of that shitty sinking ship.
Listen, as long as he's one of those 44 subscribers that's not one of us, I'm totally okay with it. Because
I'm 37 for me.
I'm not even subscribed to us.
You piece of shit.
You know, I always question if your heart was in it, Jared, even when I was just a listener. Yeah.
I don't think I'm subscribed to anything either, so.
Well, I mean, you're barely alive.
True.
Damn.
I'm only on the podcast until next St. Patrick's Day, so it's fine.
I was going to say, technically, you showed up enough that, like, we banked your appearances for, like, 3 years at this point.
Yeah.
We can just superimpose you into the rest of them from now on. I've learned enough at this point.
Just sit here like this whole time.
He's worn that same shirt for 2 years straight.
Just cut me out of this video.
Yeah. You can put your face on like other people's bodies. Just right.
It's a bunch of Getty images of Kevin.
Well, I mean, McColo doesn't talk a whole lot normally, so we could just like superimpose Kevin's face in McColo's body, and nobody would know.
I don't think anybody in the room would know either. Oh man, that was like the one thing I pointed out when I was listening back to the podcast. I was like, we need to get Misty on this more because she actually talks.
Yeah.
She actually was just like, hey, I have opinions and things. Yeah. I'm like, that's what we need, more of that. We'll superimpose her head on Michael.
There we go.
That'd be even more. Or on
the Ken weirdest farm of
Keep the beard.
Ever.
Yeah.
Keep the beard so be Misty's face.
We love you, Michael.
So, James is doing shitty. Any particular reason?
Not really. I just got bubble guts.
Okay. Yeah, I do too. That's why I'm drinking beer.
Perpetual bubble guts.
I'm gonna push it out.
Yeah.
Yeah, it makes me like.
The only way out is through.
Get it out. Yeah.
True.
Usually I drink coffee in the morning and then I'm great after my first poo, but that didn't occur this morning.
So that coffee lubed poo is one of the greatest.
So good. You got to have the brown gold.
Especially if you have
the black gold to have the brown gold.
It goes from preemptive to triage pretty quickly.
It does indeed.
I love it.
Do either of you guys own a squatty potty?
No, I squat myself. So
there you go.
Actually, true story. Now that you bring it up, this morning, right around when I needed to take my morning duke at work, I went to sit down on the toilet and I put down my little paper doily because I'm, worried about germs and other dudes who shit directly onto the seat. And I lean over and I realize, oh shit, my shoes are a little bit too loose today. So I lean over to tie my shoes, perfect squatty potty positioning. And I didn't even have to buy one. It was so fucking nice.
Did you just like,
dude, zero friction? It just came out
like
in a full force.
Were you
force.
Like in the position? Like, were you like power squatting?
No, I did not handicap toilet? Hover. If that's just what you're asking.
Yeah.
No, this was like straight that. Like 4 points of contact on the cheeks, just bent over like this. But, you know, kind of collateral damage was, you know, there's that little vent on the toilet right there. Because I'm still, the first shoe was, oh, this is a great idea. The second shoe, I was regretting it because I was like in this fucking splash zone at SeaWorld. Like, it just was front stage. So I'm like, oh, Jesus, bro. Slow down on the fiber. Serious. And that's been your brown talk of the week, guys.
Yep. There we go. That's the brown corner.
I'm glad you brought it up, Chris. Thank you.
With the greasy dragon.
Yes. That was probably the best $25 purchase I've ever had. Was a Squatty Potty. This is not sponsored by Squatty Potty, although, hey. We can always go for
offer code SQUAT for 10% off.
Legitimately, that's like the best thing that I've ever put.
Dude, it beats the shit out of like squatting.
Literally,
on the potty,
literally,
which I've done.
Yeah, it's not fun. You think that like, oh, what you mean? I can lift my feet up and it's gonna help. And then holy shit, you don't even have to try anymore. It just
it helps you hit all those hard to reach places.
Yeah.
Yep.
It's two in one. Great.
Plus, as a man who has
it brings light to all of the dark corners of your kingdom.
Yes.
Speaking of my hairy asshole, it actually helps with that too, sir. Thank you.
Goat seed harder than I ever had before.
Listen, my flexibility is like increased because of that thing.
Has your visibility.
And so has my asshole.
Excellent.
So, aside from that, Kevin,
how dilated are you?
On a scale of like one to my kid,
oof,
where are you at?
Oh, well, I was in Georgia all weekend, and I don't shit other than my own throne. So,
you had to make
hopefully PBR
decisions.
Will help me out, because I've eaten barbecue all fucking weekend.
So, when was the last time you shit?
At the Awakening. Yeah. That's actually the first thing he does when he leaves the cave. He's like, oh, shit, it's been a year. All right, time to take a shit. Where are the guys? Assemble.
Friday before I left to go to Georgia, and I got back. No, actually, yeah, and I got back Sunday night, last night.
You went across state lines with guns fully loaded?
No, I took a shit before I left.
Oh, okay.
No,
I think that's a felony. Yeah,
I don't think they don't recognize their concealed weapons, so... But no, I was in Georgia doing a show and almost died like four times up there. It was during the tornado that we had.
Yeah.
So I was up there in a 45-foot scissor lift, shirtless, all metal. I'm like taking chains off.
Say that again, but slowly.
All metal scissor lift.
Shirtless?
Shirtless.
Oh, I'm so close. Shirtless.
Sorry, guys. Is your bathroom still open?
in the rain, and my boss is yelling at me, and lightning's popping all over the place. So I might as well just anchor myself and start taking chains off. So if lightning pops me, I'm just going to die. Why not? And on the way back into town, I drove through two tornadoes and a hailstorm with a big ass trailer attached to my truck. Nice. And I looked at the kid that was riding with me. I'm like, hey, we're going to go. He didn't like that very much.
Jesus.
Meanwhile, I'm having first world problems over here. I'm at work and I'm like, I need to watch the hockey game because I'm paid to do that. Wait, go to NBC. That's the channel that it's on. Why is it talking about the storm that's not hitting us? There are 12 people dead in Georgia. Fuck you. Where's the hockey game? You assholes. Anyway, this is when I learned that I am a real piece of shit.
But then at
the
same time...
that out like upon joining the villains?
I mean, honestly, I figured that out like in high school.
Hey, that's when we became friends.
Yeah, that's when I figured it out.
When I realized my standards are really low. Hi, James. My name is Chris.
I should get friends. I was like that cat sitting at the table with like a newspaper in front of me. I should get friends. I decided to be nice for once in my life and then not nice to anybody else still. It's the one thing I don't understand. It's the one thing that Nikki doesn't understand about me, because everyone's like, Chris is a fucking asshole. Like, he can be a dick. And then Nikki's like, he's the nicest person ever. I'm like, you're only saying that because you get the dick.
He's a lot nicer like when he's been nicer, inside you.
It's a lot nicer when there's other things in this equation.
Yeah.
Anyway. So, did anyone want to talk about anything? Aside from bowel movements and Kevin shirtless?
One more time?
Shirtless.
So, normally my Mondays are really easy. I like, just drink beer all day and... like, yeah, normally I'll have a bunch of paperwork from the weekend where I tried to, like, get out of working the entire time. But today I spent like 7.5 hours on the phone dealing with other people's shit. It's not a fun day.
Just one phone call?
One phone call for one issue.
I think that's the longest.
Was it a turn off and turn back on issue?
I wish. Okay. I mean, it's my second longest phone call with the company. My first is 27 hours long.
Is it like, do you work at suicide prevention? What takes that long to figure out?
We had a...
How do I use Squatty Potty?
the Squatty Potty is in my ass now?
And that was actually like when I was fairly new to the job too. And like I wasn't charging for overtime yet because I wasn't like jaded and didn't hate my job.
You weren't like, sticking it to the man.
Yeah. Now I'm like making dinner at like 5:30 and I like walk over to my laptop. I'm like, good night, boss. And he was just like, good night. And I'm like, that's 30 minutes of overtime.
Fuck them all from the inside.
So, yeah, my actual manager had a heart attack on like Friday or Saturday. So.
Yeah. So are you going to assume that position?
Oh, no. It's like a super stressful job. And well, I don't want any more stress than I already have. Like, it's killing, like, a 35-year-old man who in his off time, like, runs marathons and professionally trains MMA fighters. Like, I'm good. I don't want that. Like, I'm, like, 240 pounds, and I like to drink beer. I will fucking die if they give me that job.
I mean, you're
like, he had a mild heart attack. I'll just go in the backyard and dig my own grave. It's fine. Like, I'm just, it's awful. I'm already like 1 foot into intestinal cancer.
So depressing.
One foot into like heart disease. Like, I don't need that.
I mean, at least you shit regularly.
I have a very regular schedule. It's free.
Having, you know, 1 foot in heart disease and constipation is not a good combination.
Yeah, you are correct. You know, you don't want to strain your heart with the constipation.
Yeah, just, oh, shit. Yeah,
I'm going.
Should have bought a Squatty Potty.
Stick your finger in and pick it out.
Well, damn.
No, sorry. It's never been that bad, folks.
Not yet, it hasn't.
I've only been constipated once.
Lucky son like, of a bitch.
It was really bad. Well, no, I've had like trouble pooping before, but like once when it was like really bad and I hated
trouble
my life.
Stopping pooping, but never going.
And yeah, like my stepmom's Chinese, so like she has the ancient Chinese secrets. Ancient Chinese secrets.
Oh, Herojo, right?
Yeah.
Welcome to my dojo.
No. All right, so they all call me
Jared Tsai.
Gabriel. Because that's my middle name, Gabe.
Gabriel.
Which was super confusing at the wedding. So
that shit was hilarious.
My Chinese family tries to call me Gabriel.
Gabriel?
And they go, Gaber! Yeah.
Hello, gay boys.
Hello, Gaber. Yeah. So it's great.
They know what they're doing.
Yeah. They really do.
So he like, called him a gay boy.
Yeah. Is that Savannah's side of the family? Or is that your...
My stepmom is Chinese.
Oh, I did not know that about you.
Yep, my dad's
Much
Viking.
Like how when... Daniel was putting, our Daniel was putting your name into his phone so he can actually save your phone number. He stopped and looked at me. He was like, what's Jared's last name? And I stopped and looked at him and I was like,
Darkness.
He told me before, but I don't remember. And he's like, I'm just going to put dark. And I'm like, I think.
Wait, is it not dark. Actually dark?
It is. No, oh, it will be.
Oh, okay. Gotcha.
It changes on
part.
February 6th. Imitates
oh, yeah. You actually did change it.
But
yeah.
I was like,
on February 6th, it'll be changed.
That's cool.
Yeah.
It's a W. I don't remember what. And then, like, yeah. 5 minutes later,
everybody's
I like,
just like,
oh,
Wilson.
I
I'm like, yeah, it's okay.
But now you're legally changing it, so
yep.
You can officially
can't help
keep
but feel
Facebook
like it's
now.
Like a missed opportunity. Warning, could be a bad joke coming. Missed opportunity to not name a child perfect. Dark.
Womp, womp,
well,
womp, womp.
Hey, I prefaced it, motherfuckers.
I'm pretty sure that's actually worse than the last 20 minutes of us talking about bowel movements.
Yeah. Yep.
We've hit an all-time shit low, guys.
You know, sometimes you just gotta go high and you gotta go low.
And dim sum you lose.
Fucking damn it!
Well, that's it, boys.
Yeah. That's all we got, podcast over.
Pack it up, gay boys!
So yeah, what was I talking about with Chinese people? I don't know.
They're at your wedding and they call you by your middle
name. Gaber.
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 Yeah. That's all I remember.
I'm going to be laying in bed and I'm just... Gabriel.
So like my mom was like super stressed out in the early portion of the wedding, and she like kept screaming, Gabe, do this, Gabe, do that, Gabe, what the fuck are you doing? And like I was started to fucking yell at my mom.
It's like, your Chris Sermon's like, ass shot of the week.
Like, yeah, it is. Get in there, girls. Well, boys.
Two thumbs could make him
yours. He's taking on the lady front.
I didn't know if you put the beers in the fridge or not.
No.
No, this right is going to get warm. No,
slow you down.
And now I can't fucking grip it.
Come on. Come on, gay boy.
It's just slipping.
You want me to get you, mommy?
You want to
get me? I gotcha.
Oh, boy.
So you had to work a little bit for that, didn't you? Are you left-handed or right-handed?
Left-handed.
I'm not
fundamentally wrong with you.
Wait, hold on. We have a perfect opportunity.
Hello! That was the most blood-curdling, like, little noise I could ever come from.
Well, if you were, like, shoved up inside of a pair of briefs, you'd be talking like that, too. You ever been shoved in a car with too many people and you're just, fuck, I just...
Yeah, all of high school, when I was, like, the chauffeur for everybody, and everybody would just be crammed into the
Did you get
bag.
Your license first?
Maybe.
Well, you definitely drove
but
me
you got
around.
Your car first.
Yeah, was it a car?
I was, when I had, I was the only one that had a car out of all my friends.
I was, and I used to drive all of my friends in high school to school, and they promised they would pay me. I never got it, so I think I might need to get restitution.
Zero blowjobs during high school.
You were to the point where like I would get money from their parents when they would realize that they never
handies,
paid
though.
Me.
Mini.
I would get handies from their parents.
You were in like Orange Park too, right?
Yeah. And we
so most
we
of those
like,
palms should have been soft then.
Yeah.
I would think.
We were like in deep Argyle, like Oakleaf Argyle, going
very
to
soft.
Orange Park High School.
Very soft.
Super soft. Which it surprised me that our high school or Orange Park was my high school with how far away I was.
Yeah.
The that closest one other opened. Than that was Ridgeview, but we were like just across the county line. Hmm. So we had to drive even further. Or I had to drive even further.
Interesting.
But I did have a really neat CD collection that I stole from everybody though, so I got that going for me.
There's that. I grew up a few blocks from Forest, so
you got that going for you, which that's, is that's, not great.
That's where I went to what is now known affectionately as West Side High.
I went to Wolfson.
Which, I don't know if that's a better name.
It is really not. Not while like Robert E. Lee and Jefferson Davis are still names of schools. Westside High is just like a blatant.
I really should have just called it Grand Wizard High.
That would have been that would have been hilarious.
You go to GWH?
Sounds like a really elaborate like D&D meeting, but you realize that, oh, they actually play the game.
He's not wearing that hood as a costume. He's wearing it as an
He's
actual...
not role-playing.
No.
It's...
His character doesn't need rope.
It's like the one thing he gets is like as a familiar.
Just rope. But he's just constantly
It's like a cantrip. He just summons rope.
Not enough mana to cast trees.
This took a turn.
Goddamn.
We don't have a black person here to balance it out, so we gotta stop. We don't even have a brown person here tonight.
Where's Eugene at?
We got Skywalker.
He actually was gonna come, but he said he wouldn't be able to be here until like 8.
Oh, well. Yeah.
Until the end of the podcast.
He'll fucking show up anyway.
Yeah, for Resident Evil Part 2.
Oh, man.
Make him play the
flute. That was the best part of that night, was after the podcast when we made Eugene play that game. It took me like 20 minutes to put the video together.
It upsets me that like I try to be funny, and it's like sometimes just the way he says things, no effort needed. It's just funny.
You're just like, he's black. That came out really good.
Yeah. I try to say it. People look at you weird. Like, what the fuck? You never listened to Tupac. They don't know that I have, but
you've actually been possessed by the spirit of Tupac.
I infamously rose from almost the dead. Off a couch and spit a hot 16 in this girl's face from Tupac Shakur's Wonder if Heaven Got a Ghetto and made this girl cry and she left the party. And then I went right back to sleep as if my purpose had been fulfilled.
And that's when you knew you were truly dead inside.
And that's when I woke up the next morning.
Did you like float down like...
No, but I guess apparently I rose off the couch like The Undertaker, like in the center of the room. Because I was fucking gone. And then I just like rose up and then got in her face.
Can you give us a recap?
Yeah, cops don't give a damn about a Negro. Pull a trigger, killer. He's a hero. Mo. Rather be a dead than a Poe. Just, you should superimpose Eugene, like, each time I pause there. Or, actually, even better, Eugene saying that word.
Yeah.
So okay. That's perfect. He said it plenty of times in the last video.
Yeah,
go watch
that video. Yeah, you did. I can pull that. He, like, brings out the black in me, and he's just like, it's okay, you went to Forest.
We were talking about...
Sorry, Grand Wizard High.
It's funny because
you shall henceforth be named
Eugene. After every podcast, like, always comes to me. He's just like, just so you know, you do have like a black person card for me. Like, he says that every podcast.
He lets you know. Yeah.
Like, it's like, dude, I know you gave it to me, like, you know, 3 months ago.
But we have this other metavillain. Patrick.
I still have it in my wallet.
It's a bit of a Tumblrette.
Laminated it, put it up on the wall.
Yeah. Listen, Tumblrette is a pejorative.
He's a bit of a pejorative.
Anyway, and then we talked about that at work, where I guess somebody was like bragging that his black friend gave him a black card, and I'm like, if you don't have that, then you're fucking stupid and racist.
I feel like that's the cool kid saying that he's cool.
No, yeah. It's the racist saying that he's not racist, is what it's saying.
That's what it sounds like. Guys,
I totally have a black card. So it's okay.
Look, it's in my wallet. Yeah.
He actually pulls out a card.
Pulls out all black cards.
He needs to step up his game.
How did you put a whole piece of rope in your wallet? Don't worry about that.
In high school, I was given a laminated piece of, like, black construction paper. one of the black girls in drama was just like, you fam. And, like, gave it to me, and I was like, I will cherish
this forever. You got proto-fammed?
Yeah.
Did it have your, like, name and expiration?
No, it was just black paper that was laminated. That's it.
Maybe it did. You just couldn't read it.
So is that, like, one of those things where, like, you're in a tough situation, you're like, I don't know what to do, and then you're like, you've activated my trap card, and you throw that card down, and it gets you off scot-free?
But then the black guy goes, you only get one, kid, and then it just disappears.
I think when, like, Tumblr comes after us, I'm just going to, like, drop that in front of the webcam and walk away. I got it somewhere.
So this somehow reminds me of a story from Orange Park High, and there was a there was a talent show at Orange Park. I think it was my junior year.
Oh great! Did someone have a baby on stage? Or did someone get like an STD on stage?
No, instead it was a bunch of shitty
performance art.
Bands.
Thank you very much.
It literally turned into a hardcore show, is what happened. It was a bunch of shitty.
Did
high
In
school.
Our Time play?
Yes, actually. And they won, I think.
Oh my god.
Jesus.
Oh my god,
I'm remembering this now.
So it was at the high school, it was in the cafeteria, it basically turned into a hardcore show. But like the section of hardcore kids, quote unquote, in our school was like divided, where it was like certain kids were friends and then certain other kids were friends. I was in one of the groups, and the other group, like, fucking hated us.
And there's the group that's,
you know, they wanted to call us posers because, you know, we never got our etnies and our skateboards, and we were never cool skater boys.
This is before Hot Topic had a good selection.
They were threatening to, like, fight us all, and we called them out, and they're like, you should fucking come to the talent show.
Let's open up this pit.
We'll go ahead and open up the pit, per se.
You good?
Okay. We'll open up the pit per se at this talent show.
Pit per se.
So we brought our friend Matt Mercurio. Shout out to Matt Mercurio. And he is one of those guys that is just like popular enough to where everybody is his friend. So what he did for us as a cool guy is that he called up every person that he knew to show up. And who are the people that show up? Like, not even fucking lying, 20 of his black friends show up. And they just fucking roll up with us, stand with us, start hardcore dancing with us, and start pushing them down. Like,
they literally have the darkness on their side.
Like, the show ended, and then we walked outside, and we just watched them all just, like, slowly back away to their mom's vehicles and just leave. And that was, like, the moment where I realized that they're all just a bunch of punk-ass bitches. I mean, I probably would have done the same, to be honest, but...
I have a similar story.
It turned into, like, 40 against, like, 10, so...
Well, I grew up on the west side of Jacksonville, so
Grand Wizard High.
I didn't actually know any white people until I was already a man.
He did not know about the white about
disease
until the white man
came. I was born into the black people, molded by them. And so,
well done.
Suddenly got even more racist than it needed to be. Yeah. So when I started getting into metal, it was actually because my best friend Sean started getting into like metal, and he used to listen to name any emo band ever. The Used, MCR.
Verb the noun.
Like hashtag easily. Return of MCR.
So, but Sean was like very much so like the blackest, biggest motherfucker in the neighborhood who had a reputation and like led an actual gang. and like was incredibly violent. And I love him dearly. And he's
why do
like,
I imagine him getting into a fight while Helena is playing in the background?
He's the sweetest guy ever. Yeah. And no, he really is. And so I was like, hey, my children, my bride's coming to town. And he was like, let's fucking go. And I was like, fuck yeah. And so we went, and he used to always like borrow my clothes whenever we would go to shows and then give them back right after because, you know, hood shit. So because
he's a daywalker.
I had like a shirt like that had like all like the bones of like the sternum and the ribs and everything. And like
I totally had one of those.
Yeah, yeah, it was like Iron Violence or whatever.
Wasn't there a My Chemical Romance version of that, too?
I don't know.
The fucking bleeding heart.
Yeah,
this didn't have that. It was just like the bones. And so he was like, oh, fuck yeah. This looks emo enough, and he'd like wear it. And so we go to this fucking show, and I'm in the pit, and like somebody like fucking pushes me into the giant pole at like the that's
no, the old Imperial, the Imperial.
And he like steps up, like, cause the dude like fucking walks up on me. He's like, this is my pit. And fucking Sean's
did he,
like,
did he say
what's
it
up?
Just like
and he
that?
Was like, it's cool, it's cool. We can
you
share.
The wrong
he swings away immediately, and I was like, oh, I should have been a black person. This is great. And then like 4 years later, I was like, well, black people got the shit end of this stick. So
that's the difference from going to hardcore emo shows and then punk rock shows that I used to go to at the Imperial.
Yeah. Oh, I mean, I got into shit tons of fights. Yeah. I'm wrong. Especially at the Imperial. I got kicked out every hardcore prom I've been to.
Yeah.
I feel like I've played a hardcore prom before.
I'm sure you were in some pretty gay bands.
True. We've went over it before.
What was it? What were they?
Hashtag I am the unicorn forever.
Not that one. I've never seen you guys play.
I don't know. What other band was I in?
Something Juliet?
No, that was Patrick was in.
Oh, that was Patrick. Okay, so I've seen them play. Yeah.
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 He was also in every other band in
Hashtag
in Jacksonville,
Jackson, the local man suck, unless you're Loki Otto or As They Suffer.
Hashtag really long hashtag.
Fuck it. I love the Lokiata.
No, no. It'd have to be hashtag superfluous hashtag.
Hashtag meta.
Hashtag yep. Never heard of her.
So, yeah.
Lokiata was great.
I enjoyed that band.
Yeah.
I don't remember if I played with them or not, but seriously, I definitely have seen them.
Lokiata?
Yeah.
Oh, Lokiata. Man. Lokiata.
Barely knew her.
Yeah,
I got a microphone cord wrapped around my neck.
I feel like I want to put Lokiana on right now while we podcast.
Who are we seeing?
Is that background music?
Was it Maylene?
No, that was an Alexis on Fire show.
And who the fuck was the band that
Trash Talk?
Oh, so
that was the name of the band was
our
Trash Talk.
Mutual friend Grant, Chris, and I. And who else were we there?
Michael was also there.
Michael was there, so he may remember this. And we were up against the stage at the Social in Orlando.
Gross.
And I remember because I got a hip bruise just from being up against the stage because hashtag pussy. And I'm sitting there and I look at
hashtag anemia.
Hashtag low iron. So I look the lead singer or whatever you want to call him in the face. And he looks at me and like we get eye contact. And all of a sudden I feel a microphone.
That was a long rip.
Hey, next time fart mic, bro.
No. I don't want
to
like
I have to then talk
give
to
the next person mouth cancer.
That's the no.
That's right? Where I draw the line. It's pink
it's
eye.
It's not the racist overtones. It's not the shit stories. It's I don't want to fart in the microphone. You're the only one who uses the red one. That's your own brand. It smells. It
I'm
smells
sorry.
Not
I'm
numbers.
Sorry.
Anyway, trash talk.
I tried.
Contact.
Jeez. I tried
oh,
it.
God.
I failed.
It's thick. I'm now sweaty. Oh, my God.
Look at your dog. He's just
you
he's
and
like,
I just showered before I came here.
He's like, that's great. Do it again.
I'm never going to be able to wear this shirt again. Fuck. My car is probably not. Oh, God, I can chew it.
Oh. You're the reason why I have to turn the AC on to like 68.
I'm sorry.
You're the reason why people have to move. Shit. Yeah, so I got a microphone cable.
Property value down.
My story doesn't matter anymore, but I got a microphone cable wrapped around my neck and I was yanked up on stage. And I looked at Grant for help, like, this is how it ends.
That band was absolute shit. Which Much one? Like your asshole right now. Trash Lounge. Trash.
They were like a really shitty, like, band that was like 40-second punk songs or whatever. And they were all not good.
That's cool.
But everyone apparently at that show was there for them and not like the headliners or anything.
And they were like Casey Jones.
Sure.
They have like 60-second long songs and all of them are.
I think feel like you can only get away with all quick songs when you're grindcore.
Yeah.
Pretty much. But that was a show that I ended up liking that other band that played before them, La Dispute. I don't know if you ever listened to them before.
No.
They're like,
other than being there,
indie hardcore, but like the singer doesn't sing. It's almost like spoken word poetry, and it actually works really well. And that's what was weird about it.
Interesting.
I don't even remember that.
They were good. Started. Are you still farting over there?
No. That was him. I swear.
Blaming it on the fucking dog.
Blaming all the antibiotics.
As he's in here like, hey guys, how are you?
Raven lit one this morning in my office. And I thought she like shit inside the house. I was just like looking for turds everywhere.
Yeah.
They have, rough.
They have him on this food that's supposed to like help digestive problems.
Yeah.
And it has a distinct smell. And then when he shits, it's the exact same smell.
This like, honestly excellent. Has to be the shittiest episode that we have ever done.
Oh, good for you. Good for you.
You were sitting here.
James, here's the dad.
You're sitting here like, oh, I can say this. I can say this joke. Because it fits.
So shit.
Now you're acting like one of those old dudes from the Muppets.
You ready for the end of the world? Could it be worse than this?
Hey, that podcast wasn't half bad.
You're right. It was all bad.
I'm going to start every podcast.
We are the old people from the fucking Muppets.
Waldorf and Sattler.
Yeah.
I never knew what their names were until just now.
I feel like an amateur now.
Even though I love the Muppets, I feel like fucking pleb for not knowing that.
I didn't. I've heard their names said 100 times and I forget
already forgotten
time.
One of them.
Waldorf and Sattler.
Yeah, Statler. Waldorf and Sattler.
Ah.
Is it Sattler? With a T?
Sounds like a new crime drama.
S-T-A-T-L-E-R.
Okay. This right summer, premiering right after Rizzoli and Isles. I was gonna say, Waldorf right and Sattler.
Right off of right after Fallen Skies.
They really do deserve their own show. I mean, if the Kardashians can have a show.
Then the Muppets can. Especially those two.
I mean, the Muppets movie.
Just.
Honestly, I'd rather see the Muppets sex tape.
Yeah.
Until, like, fucking... What was the website they got sued into oblivion because of the whole...
Gawker?
Hogan, Gawker?
I think.
Until Gawker...
Because the Hulk Hogan thing?
Yeah. Until they get sued into the ground for releasing...
For those of you that don't know, Gawker released the Bubba the Love Sponge sex tape with Hulk... Or no, maybe it was Hulk Hogan's sex tape with it Bubba was. The Love Sponge's wife... Or something like that.
It was that.
And Hulk Hogan.
You never heard
up,
about that? This was no. months ago.
Yeah. Okay. So Hulk Hogan, after the sex tape got released, and I guess apparently in this sex tape, I think Hulk Hogan used the N-word. Was that the same tape, supposedly? No. Or no, that was a separate one because there's so many.
Was he just like punching her while he was fucking her?
No, it was just normal. As far as I remember, it's just normal sex. But
yeah,
it was
just
sex
normal,
tape of
boring
Hulk Hogan.
Sex from normal people that
and
are
so,
not
so stars. Gawker.
Why do famous people tape so their lame. Sex? I don't get it.
Because they rest can of us. Sell it.
Well, either way, so,
gotcha there.
So he wasn't even there, like, solving
it. Right. It's not like I can sell my sex.
So Gawker releases it, and Hulk Hogan ends up getting bankrolled by this guy who, I don't know if he was just a lawyer or if he was rich, but he's a guy that Gawker released some of his shit in the past, but he just has fucking loads of money and basically bankrolled Hulk Hogan's case to sue Gawker to the point that they had to declare bankruptcy. And then Fun the company times. Got sold off.
This is always the most interesting part of the podcast.
Cat Gunter's coming in with this. Actually, Hulk Hogan was about 7 inches. You mean Terry Bollea or Bolila, whatever his name is?
I don't fucking know.
What?
His real name's like Terry.
Yeah, that was a story that happened like a year ago or something. It was,
yeah.
It was pretty interesting because it was like legitimately a week before Gawker had an article where it's like it was about what was that shit that happened? Or it was like Fapgate or whatever? No, what the Fappening. That's what
Fappening.
Where like all the celebrities like nudes
I remember that
started leaking or whatever.
A whole lot of Jennifer.
And it was an article that they posted that was like, if you look at this stuff, then you're just a terrible person because it's not a respecting of privacy and blah, blah, blah.
Videos
and then
you
a
may
week
like.
Later, they legitimately post his sex tape on their website for you to view. So it's like, where's that fucking double standard? Like,
I never would have known you'd get so passionate about Hulk Hogan's sex tape.
It's not even about the sex
because
tape.
Because he owns a Hulkamania t-shirt.
You know what, brother?
This is where he draws the line.
You should have just played it off like, I don't want to rip my fucking shirt ever.
No, I just can't. I'm not going to try to lie to the audience or to you guys here at home.
Great, guys. It just stretched out the neck. That's all I did.
We're not having fun.
I was going to do a bit with a broken shirt already, but I forgot it.
I forgot to pre-cut it. Fuck.
Unfortunately, we've already had one ripping of shirts on these podcasts before, and you've already done it, so we can't do it again. Like, that bit's done.
You're welcome.
Wait, like, fuck it up for the rest of us before I was even on the podcast.
I don't even remember what you were fucking yelling about.
Xbox fanboys.
I just... Every time you do that, I just hear in my head, you want to fucking go?
Yeah. And then everybody was like, yeah, we'll fight you. And then I ripped my shirt off and everybody's
what
like,
was that drive
we're
home
good.
Like? What was that drive we're home good. With like a just a ripped shirt?
Like any other drive home?
You mean like when I
you
ride
act
a
like
horse
this
in the
first time it's happened.
I went to high school at Forest.
Yeah, this isn't my first rodeo.
This time you just did it for funsies.
Yep.
There were like two buttons on the floor that Daniel found later.
That was
the
like,
first time I've ripped my shirt and not fought anybody.
It's like you can sell those when we get famous.
At this rate.
This site will forever be hallowed ground.
Yeah, we keep talking about bowel movements. It'll stay that way. But you know what? That's okay. That's totally fine. Kitty, Jesus either in or out. Christ. Jesus fucking Christ.
I don't know whether to applaud your cat on his persistence or his stupidity.
Well, the one thing that I can give credit to the cat is he taught Skywalker how to open doors. So now Skywalker can open doors. Because he used to like not try to push doors.
Next step, Skynet Online.
Because now he used to sleep in the room with us and we'd leave the door like slightly cracked so the cat can come in and out. But then he figured out, he's like, shit, I have a really big head. I just fucking fling this shit open. So now we wake up every morning, the door's just flung wide open. He's downstairs on the hardwood floor, just passed out, drunk.
You know? Fucking shitting everywhere.
You know what? Give him credit for shitting on the hardwood floors. Thank you. Thank you, Skywalker, for shitting on the hardwood floors.
You're like, I'm a big dog, but I'm not an animal.
Meanwhile, like, Raven's just, like, walking her asshole literally across the softest space she can find. She's like, yes, this will do nicely.
Just scoots across. Your dog does the scooting asshole thing?
I've seen her do it twice. So, and one time it's because she ate the interior of one of her toys and was like shitting like fuzzies. The interior of it. Yeah, she was shitting a fuzzy rope. Yeah.
Just shitting brown clouds. Yeah.
And she thought she was in trouble. Like she kept thinking she was in trouble and kept like running outside and was like, what the fuck is going on? So I walk into the living room and I see her scooting and she like looks at me and she's like, oh no. And like,
we both don't know what
outside,
to do here.
But she's like, bopping everywhere. She doesn't quite know how to like run with
stringing her
asshole. Yeah.
No one prepared me for this.
Yeah.
Meanwhile, my dog can shit on himself and just walk into the house, go right upstairs and just sit down on the carpet. And I'm like, well, you were good until now. Now you are not a good boy.
I've literally had my cat sit on our very specific comforter because I guess it has good grippage. She'll sit on the comforter, look you in your eyes. And just skid across. And the first time it happened, I was like, there's no way that this animal has evolved enough to know how good that feels. So I kind of like downplayed it. And then I'm like, oh, fuck, I should probably, is that a shadow? No, you gotta be fucking, I'm like a fucking dumbass. I lean all the way in to like sniff check it. Like any man would do with his underwear. And
this is good for one more day.
It's fair. Yeah.
Yep. That comforter was not good for one more day. Because it looked like I threw a Hershey Kiss into the bed, rolled it up, and was like, I'll find it later. That was very gross.
My cat, meanwhile, just throws up everywhere. Hmm. That's why I don't like cats.
Does your cat meow while it's throwing up?
It tries.
But it gurgles.
Yeah, it's like.
We'll just be sitting in the living room and also letting, we'll hear meowing.
It's letting Raven know that Raven can come get first breakfast.
Breakfast is cool.
Yeah. Raven eats it and is like, oh, all right, that was great. But what about second breakfast?
Exactly.
And then he pukes again.
And then I wake up and like pour her some honey bunches of dog shit. And
how many of our like 14 subscribers do you think we lost just on sheer like
all of them.
How gross shit this talks. Is?
This is the worst podcast ever.
Well, all 7 of my dummy YouTube accounts would be still be subscribed.
Ones. We have.
So, you know, at least we're all talking.
Yep.
And that's good. All I can ask for. Yeah. At this true. Point, I'd rather hear something racist, terrible, like sexist, homophobic.
I feel like we've covered all the food groups, really.
Yeah. I mean, Patrick's definitely going to leave after this one.
We know LOL Trump's America.
You just build a wall around that topic.
You got to give him a chance. I mean,
there's only been one Monday in office.
In there.
Oh, man. I'm just saying, he already brought back like 2,000 jobs. Because, you know, 2,000 versus 160,000 a month. You know, that's good numbers.
Hey, kids at home, go try to look up the White House website in Spanish.
What? No.
Also, tell me where.
It's no es aquí.
Tell me where the gay rights are on it. I'd say like LGBTQ, but they're. That. Did you guys see that those definitions got expanded a lot?
Where?
It's no longer LGBTQ,
it's LGBTQ
plus.
Plus, I don't know.
G plus apparently, K plus
apparently
something.
There's an it's A. Like, there's an A in it now.
Yeah, and there's also P for pansexual. And I was like, sure. Right, because let's compare your woes as somebody who's attracted to somebody's brain, because you know you guys have been persecuted so much throughout time, whereas like I don't know, lesbians and gays have been literally called firewood. Which is where the word faggot comes from, because they would just burn them. Yeah, yeah, you've had a lot of trials and tribulations there. I really like your brain matter. Fuck off. And K for kink, are you fucking kidding me?
Is that really what
I
K
will
is?
Fuck
is that
a woman's sexual, butt. That's a sexuality? I will tie her up, I'll choke her while I fuck her. I don't give a fuck. That is, we all have kinks. I'm sorry if I got spit on you.
No, that is my kink.
That is kink.
Yeah,
that is kink.
Let me just warn you next time. I'll open my mouth.
It doesn't fucking matter. I fuck you like I just raided your fucking village and killed your father. That's how I fuck.
Okay, so I would like to call attention to the fact that, like, if I said that with like this little fledgling beard, people be like, wow, somebody call the police because that's a pervert. If you have somebody that looks like his name should be like Nord Fjord Horde. You know what? That's discrimination. Did you just assume my ethnicity?
I definitely assumed you weren't a man.
I made that assumption too. It took me almost 30 years to grow this. If I had a beer, I would tap it too. Yes.
Tap for pussies.
It's the spirit of my empire.
Yeah, there we go.
We're all just giant pussies on the inside. So let's be real.
Also, props to me for trying to come up with like a semi-Viking name out of nowhere. That really was just gibberish.
So that mean James is coming out with us on St. Patrick's Day this year?
Yeah, it does.
Yeah, you're going to come out with us on St. Patrick's Day.
That works.
Get ready to get riggedy riggedy.
Get ready for a hangover and some possible charges.
It's gonna be rough. It's gonna be rough.
Just give me a call.
If it was, if it's anything like Nick last year.
Ooh, that may be the last day I ever see Kevin.
Yeah, probably.
That may be the last day I ever see any of you guys, except when I bail you guys out. But that'll be like part of the trip.
No, you'll bail them out. I'll be dead behind a bar somewhere.
Or you'll be dead in the cell with them. Because
possibly.
You didn't make it. I don't know. These are all hopes and dreams.
So I'm gonna make a final closing on this. President Trump does a lot of... And that's all I got.
You heard it here first.
Are you going to try to turn it off yourself?
No. We're like 44 minutes.
Oh shit. All right. So here's my problem with Trump's three-tier.
That was a gross misjudgment on my part. I apologize, friends. Yeah, we're at 44 minutes and 46 seconds. So let's.
All right, vamp for 15
let's
minutes.
Let's try to shovel out.
Hey, Kevin, where were you during the storm? Yo ho, yo ho.
Yeah, exactly.
Where were you when we stormed the beaches of Normandy?
Up on a scissor lift, shirtless.
It was actually on Dunn Avenue.
Shirtless. Shirtless. Shirtless.
So, I mean, like, now that we blew our load, what do we do for 15
yeah.
minutes?
Yeah, seriously.
Because my refractory period is longer than gold. This.
Eugene.
I'm waiting for someone to bust through the door.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Oh, we have somebody else that can talk. Well, at least it would be Eugene, because Eugene would talk. He'd be like, let me tell you about all the things that I hate. And he would have a list as long as ours.
I tell you what, on our Switch podcast, he came in like thoughts ready, guns blazing, just straight up like stepped in the building and was like, Nintendo's a bunch of punk bitches doing punk bitch shit.
I agree with his assessment on that. I haven't listened to our old Switcheroo.
But yeah, I didn't either. And I was here.
I listen to every episode that we do.
And you edited it.
And that's why you're our one true fan.
Yeah.
Even still, come at me, Matt.
It's legitimately, at this point, I'm too... when it comes to the podcast, I'm too lazy to, like, listen through the entire thing. So, like, I'll get a message from, like, Dan. He's like, hey, the sound kind of bottoms out at, like, 33 minutes.
Suck my dick, Dan. I don't give a shit. You do it.
The sound bottoms caps. Out and it, like, it just pops out because it's too loud. And I'm like, I'm not going to go back and fix that. Like, it's just... And once the content is better than maybe.
Where we're at. But I don't know. I feel like we're at record highs tonight.
We're definitely on point of our game, trying to end the podcast like 25 minutes early.
I mean, to be fair, last week's episode was like only 50 minutes.
It
was like 50, 55.
But I feel
minutes.
Like we've made up for it with episodes that were longer than an hour.
Yeah, there's a couple episodes that went like an hour and 10, hour and 15.
Definitely. I feel like that's the norm ever since we moved over here.
Yeah.
I mean, ever since James joined.
Ever since we actually had the fuck was that?
It was the fridge.
That was the compressor kicking on the fridge.
Gotcha.
Yeah, it's getting louder and louder every day. It's not good.
No.
But I don't know anything of how to fix it, so I'm just going to let it ride.
Cool.
Until it's super annoying. Which it already is, so got that going for me, which is nice.
How long are these cables?
20 feet?
You guys in for a treat.
Oh, God.
What are you doing?
Now it's a podcast.
Panavision.
Oh, watch it spike.
Wait.
I love I think that I have to poop
in the dark. Potty in there.
Like we're going to go in there.
I'm afraid the fan's going to get caught while I'm trying to poop. So I'm going to bring this as a flashlight and just poop in the dark. I don't want to ruin our audio quality, yeah, but I want to poop.
Because that's the thing that's.
So just yell.
What are we yelling about?
This is literally the shittiest moment on this entire podcast.
Yeah, so to anybody who's listening to this, number one, I apologize. Number two, fucking Jared just went into the bathroom. And as a gentleman, he didn't turn on the light because there is a fan that goes on with the light.
Is this stuck to the TV?
I try.
No, you can pull it up. And you can just...
We're going to go behind the scenes.
It's not going to go
It's not going to go that far.
Hey, Jared. Hey, Jared.
Yo.
How you feeling in there?
It's good. I'm enjoying your squatty potty.
Right? Isn't it like the best
$25? It's like the fucking best invention ever.
What?
It's the best invention ever.
Yeah, and all it is a fucking little stool for your...
For your boo hole.
Yeah, well, you know, whatever. No, that was behind the scenes. Jared's taking a shit on the podcast. We've hit new woes.
Yeah, we really did.
Hashtag blessed.
Hashtag brown blast.
So yeah, be careful with that toilet, man, because it's gone through hell and back already.
It's a real jumper.
No, it actually leaked through the fucking ceiling before, because apparently it wasn't like caulked correctly. So that was disgusting to have to explain to my fiance that that water that's not coming from the. It's not coming from the tub. It's coming from the shitter.
Well, I know when the wax rings go bad on them, too, it can leak.
Yeah, that's apparently what happened. Is like one of the rings was like not properly installed. I don't know. It took them 4 days to figure that out.
Jeez.
Because they're like, well, we just want to see if it still leaks after we just did this. And then I'm like, but what about the giant hole in my fucking ceiling? Well, we just need to know what's wrong before we patch it back up. Because they patched it back up once and thought it was fixed, and it did not get fixed because then it leaked again. So that was fun to watch the guy be scared of my dog, number one, which was even funnier.
The Corgo.
Oh my god. This guy was terrified of fucking dogs.
The hell was that?
You said, oh my god, and somebody's Siri went off.
Hey Siri.
Oh, she knows here.
Oh my god. That was fucking weird. The audio is probably not even going to pick that up either, so we just tangent off for no fucking reason.
But why did everybody look at the bottom left all of a sudden?
He legitimately, like, refused to come into my house when I wasn't here and the dog wasn't up because he was afraid that my dog was going to bite him.
But it's Skywalker.
And...
come here.
Yeah, to anybody who, like, doesn't know, my dog is the sweetest dog ever, as you can see.
A.K.A. the newest member. The only I guess technically he's an older member than me.
The only member. Hey, how are you?
Hey, buddy.
What do you got to say?
Can you not back the barrel up on me?
Sorry.
What are your thoughts on Browngate 2017? He's like, oh, I don't know what to do.
Very, very strong and profane words. Very good. Very good. Jared!
Yo!
How's it going? This is literally like the worst 10 minutes.
This is what happens when he checks out 15 minutes early. It's just
he just copped out of the whole fucking thing is what happened.
Literally shitty filler going on right now.
He was like, oh shit, we have 15 minutes. I have nothing to talk about.
Well, I'm gonna take
just
a crap.
Gonna go take a shit. Yeah. Well, and it's going to be fucking great.
My work is done here, boy.
And we're only at 51.
You know what? We should probably end it anyway.
Let's stop.
Yeah. Sorry, guys.
Sorry again. Hope you like it.
What do I hit?
Hit the
can
stop.
Can I turn on the light now?
Yeah.
Yes, you can turn on the light.